US troops patrolling the volatile and dangerous Afghan-Pakistan border.
Fire.
Stamping out al-Qaeda and other militant groups here is seen as a vital part of the fight against terrorism. Pakistan may be a key US ally, but the relationship is far from harmonious. Washington is not convinced Pakistan is doing enough to tackle terrorism on its patch. That lack of trust isn't the only blot on this crucial relationship. Pakistan is calling for an end to US drone strikes on its territory, the latest suspected strike just 4 days ago. At home, Pakistan is facing a barrage of problems, a faltering economy, widespread poverty, and corruption. The man tasked with helping to steer the country through troubled times, Prime Minister Yousuf Gilani, and his position and government are under threat. Last month, Pakistan's Supreme Court convicted the Prime Minister of contempt for refusing to reopen corruption proceedings against the President, Asif Ali Zardari. Critics said Gilani would struggle to remain Prime Minister. There was even talk of another coup. But Yousuf Gilani, so far, remains in power.
In most other countries around the world, if a politician, never mind a prime minister, is convicted of a crime, if only on moral grounds, he would resign. Will you?
According to my assessment and according to most of the parliamentarians and even all the coalition partners, they think that whatever I have done, it's according to the constitution.
I ask the question again, will you resign?
If I'm disqualified. If I'm disqualified, notified by the speaker, yes, I have to.
Who is running the country in your absence?
In fact, according to the constitution in my country, I have a cabinet and everybody is working under the prime minister.
I ask about who's running the country because it is important to the likes of, for example, Hillary Clinton, that they know that somebody is in charge. Clinton has said that Pakistan needs to do more to fight global terrorism. To quote her, she said, "We look to the government to do more. We need to make sure its territory is not being used as a launching pad for terrorist attacks anywhere." Your response?
We had excellent cooperation in the intelligence and with the ISI and the CIA and all high-value targets in the world of al-Qaeda. They have been achieved through the cooperation of CIA
she
and
says
ISI.
The Al-Qaeda chief is
I'm coming to this point. And when we have achieved all high-value targets jointly, if there is any credible or actionable information, please share with us.
Why haven't you arrested Hafiz Saeed, thought to be the mastermind behind the attacks in Mumbai in 2008?
We are waiting for some concrete information and evidence.
The states seem to believe that there is enough evidence to suggest that the al-Qaeda leader is in Pakistan. Look me in the eye and tell me what more you need.
If there is any credible, actionable information, please share with us because we are already working with you. Mm. My ISI is working with CIA. What else do you want?
Quite frankly, the CIA don't trust the ISI anymore.
That's a trust deficit from both sides. That's not a case of United States alone. This is also from Pakistan as well.
There was a trust deficit on both sides, the CIA and the ISI.
No, that's a trust deficit between both the countries, between both the governments. That is the reason we are wanting to work for a new terms of engagement and cooperation with the United States.
Given Pakistani perceived lack of will, and this is coming from the states, to fight terrorists on home soil, is it no surprise that the US continues to launch drone attacks inside your country?
We always take drones as counterproductive and it's not lawful.
So what do you say to Hillary Clinton when you hear her line, "We look to the government to do more"? What are you doing?
I think now it's the time that they should do more.
In a Gallup poll released within the last year, less than one third of Pakistanis have confidence in national government, in local police, or the honesty of elections. 81% see their government as rife with corruption, and only 20%, one in five, approve of their national leaders. You being one of those. This is a damning indictment, Prime Minister, of what is, let's be frank, a dysfunctional society.
Either you say democracy or you say dictatorship. And if you want to go for a democracy, then you have to respect the will of the people.
A third of Pakistanis want to leave the country. That's what the latest Gallup poll says.
And why don't they leave then? Who is stopping them?